and Stacy and Beckett. Thanks, everybody. All right. We've got a very special tribute video for Marty. We'll call your attention to the City Open video screen up above the stadium right now. It's a beautiful video.
He's a markedly talented, bright, intelligent, he's charismatic. I would be surprised if he was incredibly successful after tennis. He's an amazing golfer, he's an amazing athlete. I think it's just sort of naturally to him.
It's been amazing to see his career. I mean, he's done great things for U.S. tennis. Been huge for the Davis Cup teams. Saved our butts a few times.
The guy can do it all. He was incredible. Singles and doubles player. All four games. Sweetest backhand you've ever seen.
Great Davis Cup player. Great Davis Cup teammate. How about in Colombia? He won all three matches in five sets. His shirt was bleeding. His pants were, his legs were bleeding. The whole thing. And he still won.
You know, if we needed him for doubles, if Bob or Mike were out, he would jump in. He would do anything you want him to do on a Davis Cup team, and that's the kind of teammate you want.
Representing his country, we've done a lot to him. Being a number one American, I know he took a lot of pride in that. He also took a lot of pride in mentoring the next generation of American players.
He was always been a good guy, who's always helped and mentored as much as he can, and that's really good too.
He's one of the first guys I ever practiced with that as an agent professional. So, he's always been a close friend of mine.
This game of tennis, you know, you travel all the time, and it takes its toll mentally, and he was able to stay pretty strong. He's in the top 10 towards the end of his career, and he had some great success. So you just kind of try and ask these guys a few questions and just kind of pick their brains a little bit for stuff that can help you in the future.
I'm happy to see him go out on his terms, and, you know, hopefully he still has the ability. Hopefully he can get some matches under his belt and make a run.
He's been a mentor the last few years, and it's been well appreciated, so hopefully he can finish strong at the Open and have a great career.
We love you, we're all going to miss you, and we hope for the best.
We're going to miss you, Marty. Thanks for all you've done for the sport. Make me a great dad. I know you will be. And now I'd like to bring out a young man who's the voice of tennis. Nobody knows more about the game. Nobody's a better television commentator than this. And also a great friend of Matt Marty's. Would you welcome to the center court, everybody, Brett Haber. How you doing, Brett?
Hey, everybody. We just thought that we would do a quick informal Q&A with Marty before the conclusion of the presentation. So I'll hold back in while you do this. You want to pass him off. Come on out. So, Marty, you have travel all around the world. You've been seven in the world. You've won titles. You've made impacts, Grand Slams. You've become a global star. What will be your biggest memories that you take away from this amazing career?
The friendships that I've made. This is 15 long years. It's nice for me to be able to go out on my own terms. I've had a few struggles in the past couple of years, but a lot of great years, a lot of great memories that will certainly override that. It's nice to come back here one more time. It's nice to go back to Atlanta and Cincinnati and ultimately the U.S. Open one last time.
You've done so many things individually, and this is an individual sport, but those comments included your buddy Andy Roddick, to whom you go back all the way with Andy, Bob, and Mike Bryan. Where will winning the Davis Cup with your buddies for the United States rank on the list of things that you achieved in your career?
Yeah, it was. I wasn't actually part of it. It felt like I was part of the team.
You were there.
I was certainly there, and it was a long process. And there were a lot of people that were, a lot of players that were involved throughout the years. And we felt like it was a process from 2002 all the way through to 2007 when they and we did win it. So it was certainly a special time.
We saw Leighton out here today and yesterday with his son Cruz getting to experience it firsthand. What will it mean to you that in this last kind of farewell tour that this young man Beckett gets to see Daddy do his thing?
Yeah, it's pretty special. It's a cool thing for Leighton to have Cruz there, and 6 years old, so he's kind of understands, I guess, what's going on. He did make a comment working for you guys on the Tennis Channel this week, and I think he thinks I'm a a broadcaster instead of a tennis player, but you know, it's nice to have them on the road. They've been such a huge part of my success and traveling.
So this match that just ended with John winning, that was your first official match as a broadcaster. How'd it go?
I don't know. You're going to have to ask. I thought it went okay, but who knows?
All right, last thing. Just if you'd like to address this crowd, you've been to Washington so many times. Just some final thoughts as you say so long.
Yeah, I mean, I certainly wanted this to be part of my last few tournaments, and so I will remember this tournament as one of my favorite of the year. I came here as a fan. When I was a junior player, you know, I'll remember great memories from here. So thank you very much for your support throughout the years.
Well, Marty, I... How's it?